Hi, I'm Nicole Sandler. I'm a volunteer at Broward County Animal Care and Adoption Center in Fort Lauderdale. Now, before the stay-at-home orders to combat the coronavirus, I spent most weekends at the shelter, walking and loving on the dogs and helping to match them with the right humans who'd come by looking to add a four-legged family member. Now, the shelter has transitioned to a virtual process where people can browse the photo listings of our residents at broward.org/animal/adoptions. So the shutdown has been heartbreaking, but millions of people nationally have stepped up to either adopt or foster a pet for the duration of the quarantine period. Now, my favorite kind of foster is one that ends as a foster fail. That is, the foster family realizes that their newest addition is now a permanent family member, but there will inevitably be those who will be returned to the shelter. So I decided to try to help the fosters by finding out a bit about the dogs they're caring for and making a series of these short videos to help them find forever homes. Because the last thing I want is for these dogs to go back to the shelter. So today I introduce you to Dottie. Dottie's ID is A2021322. Before the pandemic hit, Dottie had already been one of our longest residents at Broward Animal Care and Adoption. She arrived on May 23rd, 2019. And as you can see from this video I shot of her a couple of months ago, she's just as sweet as can be.
This is Dottie. I got to get all, I should have taken her happy. her kennel card information.
Well, she has it.
She's right. Hi, pretty girl. Hi, pretty girl. This is Dottie. Aren't you cute? Too long. You smell the treats in that bag.
Thankfully, Dottie was fostered by Jennifer and her family, so I thought we'd check in on them and see how they're doing.
It's been going really well. She's been with us for 2 weeks. She's adjusted very nicely. We do actually have two other cats that live with us. That's probably been the bigger challenge. But overall, we haven't had any issues, and she's definitely accustomed to living in home now.
I see from the pictures, she looks like she's made herself at home. So I'm interested, you have cats at home. One of the things we know about Dottie, and I think one of the reasons she's been at the shelter so long, is that we were under the impression she needed to be the only animal in the house. But you have cats.
Yeah, we have two cats. It hasn't been that big of a deal, to be honest. If the cats sort of stay in one area of the house, they don't necessarily cross paths. We haven't had any major incidents. It's more so if the cats react swiftly. And I think that's just any dog's kind of nature is going to be, you know, to chase an animal, whether it's a cat, a duck, a squirrel, you know, another dog. It's just a matter to chase, either to play or, you know, for other purposes. But we've done the best we can to keep them separate for as much as possible. We're slowly starting to introduce them. But for most of the day, she knows they're here, but she doesn't actively seek them out. And the cats know that Dottie's here, and, you know, they sometimes come around the corner and see if she's still here. And then, oh, yep, she is. Back to the room we go. It'll be a gradual project, but I'm very determined to make it work.
Awesome. Now, you are fostering her, meaning that she is still available for adoption. Any chance this might turn into a foster fail in which she becomes part of your family?
So everyone that knows me keeps saying that this will be a foster fail. I have sort of made up my mind that I will not take her back to the shelter unless she drastically takes a turn for the worse and does start to harm my cats. She's a great addition to our family right now. So if it's meant to be and someone comes along and is a good match for her, I will relinquish my maternal grasp on her and give her to someone else. But other than that, she'll more than likely be here for quite some time.
Oh, I love it. And I'm so glad she's doing well. You sent a bunch of pictures, which I've been showing throughout, and she looks very happy. So Jennifer, on behalf of all the volunteers who we're all, you know, missing the dogs, it's rewarding. It's so comforting to know that they're going out to homes. And I thank you so much for taking Dottie in. We'll put out this video. Maybe someone will want to adopt her, but it sounds like she's already got a home.
Thank you so much.
If you're interested in meeting Dottie, reach out to Broward Animal Care and Adoption Center via the website at broward.org/animal/adoptions or call 954-359-1313. Dottie's A number is A2021322. 1322. But we have lots more cats and dogs still in need of good homes. So go to Broward.org/animal/adoptions and start looking. Thanks for watching. Thanks for taking care of our animals. I'm Nicole Sandler. See you next time.